So we are mere minutes away from the final trip of Grimm's uterus. Grimm, how are you feeling? You had to take all your clothes off and put on mesh net underwear. And super dry.
I have to wear the flipper. This. I'm uncomfortable. I am angry. I'm gonna have to pee in that thing.
She's got to pee in here, and I've got to drink. They said she's got to pee in it, and I've got to take a couple of sips of it. So something about being in the room.
I am
there.
So fucking hungry. My stomach is growling, and I can't have any food.
That's not your stomach growling. That's your uterus saying, "Don't kill me, please."
I'm in pain right now. I'm not.
Bag full of Kool-Aid they left for us. Beautiful picture bombing bird.
And what?
We are just waiting. I've put all her clothes in this bag. She is currently on to pee in it. That's where we're at right now. She's going to come out of the bathroom in just a second with the pee cup. Let's see. Just give it a second. She'll be right here. And there she is.
I see my cup.
You guys want to see a cup of pee? Hello, Constance. Look at. Oh my God! You were afraid you weren't going to get very much in there. That thing's filled up.
Drink the whole thing.
I got to drink the whole thing.
No.
God.
You need to drink all
of it. Oh right, gotcha.
I gotta take my nose ring out. My glasses off. I don't want to. Oh, this hurts so bad.
So yeah, guys, we are in the pre-op postal fabricational areas. She got the man socks on. She's got a diaper on.
I hate it.
My mission is to make her laugh so much that she pees her new diaper. Constance says she will be by your side in spirit. Do not be afraid.
So they came in here and they jabbed her in the hand and gave her some meds.
So the nurse, Tiffany, that did this is the roughest and the most pain I've felt from a needle ever. Everybody's always been really good at it. I don't think she's got a good hand at it. Okay?
She's got a good hand.
She doesn't have a good hand at, you know, sticking people with needles.
And then they stuck this heater in Grimm's ass. You can see here that this is going to heat up. And it goes right up here and then back into.
Yeah.
Just to give her a nice, good, heated internal. But yeah, guys. So now we wait for more. More. She got Tylenol.
Yeah.
Look at how that cord literally looks like it's going up her ass.
It's supposed to be a heater, but it's only heating right here. It's only heating right here. What kind of heater is that?
Robot heater.
Dryer lint comes out of it. I'm gonna.
It's probably just somebody's running a dryer and they just stuck it in there. Like, yeah, I mean, we got two jobs today. We could kill two birds, one dryer, two.
Oh, they freaked me out. They came in here and said that, you know, it's a total hysterectomy, remove ovaries. I'm like, no, my ovaries stay. You do not take my ovaries, so I don't want them to take my ovaries. Guys, I want you to know I didn't consent for them to take my ovaries. Do it. I want everybody to help me sue. There's no reason to take them.
But get that damn uterus the hell out of here. Drop, get that thing off the top of the building.
I'm taking tubes too, but I'm keeping my ovaries.
Bye bye tubes. Bye bye
this
you.
This still hurts. Why does it still hurt? She's not good at this. I did not want her coming back in.
The last time you had that in you, you weren't taking stuff in. You were getting stuff out. They're giving you sedative now. It's gonna feel a little bit different. It's gonna hurt a little bit more.
Yeah, but I mean, being stuck like that, she didn't know what she was doing. Obviously,
she was she had her hand over her eyes when she did it too.
I think
she
was just
she was just kind of
feels like she didn't know what she was doing.
So how's that heat working up your ass now? Is it working?
I can only feel it like right in one area.
In your ass.
In my ass.
I only feel it in one area. My ass. My ass. Okay.
I feel like if they're gonna go do surgery on me, what if the room is cold? I don't want to be unconscious and cold.
I don't think you'd be cold if you're unconscious. I think cold is a conscious feeling.
I don't think so. I think I'm gonna be in prison in a hell. Where am I going? If I'm gonna be knocked out, where am I going?
To a dream.
I don't like it.
You were dreaming just last night.
Yeah, but this is a different dream I don't have.
You probably won't even remember. You'll probably, this will start working, and in like a few minutes, you'll wake
what
up.
What if I'm in like,
why would you be in a coma?
What if I'm in a coma and think of a different family?
That's not a coma. That's called, what do you call it? Oh my God. What do you call it? When you, amnesia. That's called amnesia. That's not a coma.
No.
Amnesia is when you forget who you are. A coma is when you're just perpetually asleep. You're just, it's like, somebody's not in a coma going, who am I? Because then they wouldn't be.
Let me just say, when it was time to come back here, Matt was nowhere to be found. Nobody could find Matt. Probably fucking
worse. Oh, if I would be so lucky. So yeah, as soon as Grim goes back to surgery, I'm gonna go find me a hot nurse.
Okay.
Ugh, no, they have uteruses. Pass. Hard pass.
You were with me and I had a uterus?
Not for long.
Shut up.
You
suck.
I'm helping her not be nervous, guys.
I am angry that she stuck me like that. I do not like her, and I don't want her around me again. I was like, yeah, you're pretty fucking rough at it. She just looked at me like...
She looked at you, and then she fucking thumped it. Yeah. Like, how about this, you bitch? So, yeah, we're just waiting on surgery. This is what Grim's going to be dreaming about while she's in surgery. Some weird black and white movie. Mark my words, she'll remember it.
I'm glad I can remember you.
Midnight Train to Paris. Okay.
Right.
You want to say goodbye to your uterus? This might be the last chance you get.
Yeah,
Reese's Pieces uterus. Stay rotten, even if you're dead. Alright, guys, so it is 1 something.
You didn't even tell me.
Forever. Yeah. It's almost time. It's almost time.
They got us here. They wanted us here at 9 o'clock. And we've just been waiting this whole time.
Grim has been terrified about them taking her ovaries. She has told everybody that walked in here.
Well, because the nurse that came in stated that they're taking my ovaries. I'm like, no. Don't fucking do that shit. What's wrong with you? Who told you to do that? I want to know who put that in there. They're like, we don't know who put them. I want to know who put it in there. I need to know. Was it Tiffany?
Was it Tiffany? She apparently wanted those ovaries, and when she found out she wasn't going to get them, she was rude to you with your IV. Like, I need no ovaries today. Fuck you, bitch.
Oh no, Tiffany
did that. You ready to surgery, Reed?
This says dentures. I don't have dentures. All my teeth are real. Have all my dentures.
So yeah, we'll be going back soon. Grim will be back on camera, dopey as fuck.
I gotta take my nose ring out. I'm gonna be dopey as fuck. So stupid.
You're gonna be dopey as fuck.
You can
help me. Okay. Hey, me and Des roaming around the hospital, and she made me come up all these stairs. I don't know if you can see that. She's out of breath too.
Seven floors.
I'm so proud of her. Can you read Braille?
That's a
Sistara. What?
Sistara.
Sistara. Stare
in. Lord. Sistara.
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 Idiots.
I'm
gonna
go for
Yeah, you are. You better come on. Oh. Oh. Oh.
Thank you,
Ben.
I'm
going. I don't have a boy. Now back downstairs. Go again. No way. They're going.
Hey, I see your hand.
They're going down.
That's a nice hand. Stupid. I think you're a man.
I saw your hand. I think you're a man.
You got very manly hands.
All right. Still waiting on Graham to get out of surgery. I had to bring Des to the spiritual center because she needed Jesus. Look at this place, dude. Can we have this room? Des is way over there. She wants to go take a sip out of the holy water. Have you found Jesus?
No.
Oh. He's right there, dude. How did you miss that? He's right there. Look.
That's Jesus?
Yeah.
I thought it was a woman.
No, that's Jesus. There he is. I'm the Phantom of the St. Vincent's Opera. You're supposed to applaud. I played the piano for you. My adoring fans, thank you.
You
thank
suck.
You for this opportunity to play this awesome machine. That's my music. Put my music back down. I'll lose my place.
I think I just made that person lose their place. I just threw the pen.
Uh-oh. Church is going to be bad on Sunday, and it's your fault. Jesus is going to be angry at you. You broke the pen. You broke a holy pen test.
Oopsies.
Oopsies. What we do here at Jurassic Park is we harvest the dinosaur DNA straight out of the amber.
It's not a dinosaur. It's you.
I don't know. He's got really short hair, though. I have way longer hair.
That was you a few years ago.
That's fair. So we collect the dinosaur DNA from the amber. And that's what makes all the dinosaurs here in Jurassic Park. You wanna see something crazy? Oh,
Jesus is eating feet.
Oh my God, what is Jesus?
It's my mom.
Jesus is eating Grimm's feet.
No, my mom is Jesus.
Oh. That's holy. Holy shit. Oh no!
It smells like chlorine water.
It does, ugh. And your hand smells funny too.
It's because it's not that.
Here, you sit down and I'll preach to you. Sit on the front row.
Hello. Hello, ladies and gentlemen of the congregation. Thank you for coming today. You could have brought some friends. It's very lonely in here right now. Just me, you, and
Casper?
Jesus. Not Casper, Jesus. You're a terrible Christian. And tonight, oh shit, we're in trouble. We gotta go.
Oh, you wanna use the stairs, do ya? You gotta pay the toll. Oh, you wanna use the hospital stairs? You gotta pay the toll.
Watch me get up with this thing. Did it. Grim's alive. She made it. Say hello to your adorning public.
Hello.
She's alive, guys. It's all your good wishes that made this happen. She's not completely awake yet. I promised you medicated. Here is medicated.
I think I'm gonna vomit.
Okay, I'm gonna go get you water then. Hey guys, I'm here with Grim Solace. We're heading home for the hospital. She is only in a little bit of pain.
I'm in a lot of pain.
She's in a lot
it's
of pain.
Like I've been
sucking off a robot. Everything tastes like nasty robot.
And it feels like she's been sucking off a robot. Her surgery was done by a robot. Was there some sort of inappropriate behind curtains business with robots?
Maybe.
Prim. Damn hospitals. Such a quack. Guys, we are going to go and search for a CVS to get these pills filled. This will be the end of the video. I hope you enjoyed everything. I really hope you enjoyed the video with me and Des. We had a really fun time just fucking around in the hospital. That's about all we got. Thank you guys for all the good wishes and the vibes. And fucking, we will see you guys in the future. Till then, stay rotten.
Stay rotten.
Give blood. And get yourself checked.
Yes, please.
Often and always. We're too old for this shit.
Yeah.
We'll talk to you guys later. Stay rotten.
Stay rotten.
Hey, guys.
Hello.
It is the 22nd. It has been 4 days since Grim came out of her surgery, and we want to give you a little update on everything going on. It'd be very informative if anybody's going through the same issues. But first, me and Carrie know that you have, of course, lost your uterus, and we pulled our money together to get you a new one.
This is what you were hiding over there.
Yep.
I got a goddamn uterus.
A new uterus. Yay, Al.
Holy shit.
It looks just like you. It looks just like yours. I should have got like a little black puffball for a fibroid.
Oh my god, that's such a goddamn garbage piece of shit.
Okay, so
how happy it is.
Let me swap
my
up and I want an explanation.
Uterus is chopped up somewhere.
Yeah. This is a way better looking uterus. It's not tainted.
So happy.
Okay, so 4 days after surgery, give us the everything.
Okay, well, I need to start with the first 3 days, I wasn't able to poop, and it hurt really bad. It still hurts really bad when I do fart. It is extremely painful, and the pain medication doesn't seem to cover it. Like, it just doesn't affect it. It hurts.
And they said to take stool softeners because the pain meds would make you constipated.
Yes. I can't cough. I can't yawn. I can't strain in any way. It hurts. So I'm speaking as best I can from my chest and not moving my stomach so much. So that's why I sound like this. I am constipated right now. And I did take stool softener that Matt went and got me.
Stool softener. Soft and loose. Give me the juice. The Melamuse. That's a little stool softener around.
God.
Yeah.
I can stand on my own and walk a little bit straighter when I walk. It's still like, oh, something that I love that I'm really glad for is the pain in my chest. When I do breathe in deeply, it's not as harsh anymore. It's like gone out a lot. It was the air that was trapped in my lungs and everything.
So over the past few days, you've been able to straighten a little bit more, but to begin with, you could not stand
up
straight.
I could not at all.
And you're kind of walking around the house like Tim right now.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I am. Still need a little bit of help when I want to put my legs back up here because I can't pull from here. This is like the abdomen muscles and I can't use them. So I have 5 cuts. I thought I had 4, but I have 5 incisions. And the biggest one is here, of course. But I am very glad I'm slowly and slowly getting better. And the light's flickering.
That's weird.
Okay, so making sure that wasn't just me. I am feeling extremely lightheaded right now. But I'm about to get up and try to walk around a little bit more to hopefully get this poop out.
So heads up to everybody. Take your pain meds. Take stool softener.
Yes.
Getting constipated after having your uterus out is
the
worst
most
pain.
Painful part. Yes.
Move around as much as possible, even if it sucks, and focus on your own personal healing.
Yes. The first 3 days, at least, you're going to experience the most swelling in your stomach. You're going to look extremely pregnant, and just
we know that
can't
happen.
Yeah, just expect that and know that it's going to go down. Take it easy the first day or two, especially don't do too much. Just let it heal inside a little bit more before you try to get up too much. But after a few days, get up and move around. And when you're laying there,
Be sure to move around here so you can get that air out, because if you're just sitting on the air, it's going to do nothing but be painful the whole time. You got to help yourself a little bit. What else? Can't remember what else. Just take it easy, but also move. Don't be too stagnant when you're laying there. Meow.
So, yeah, and she wants to say thank you to everybody, because there's so many people that have reached out. And number one being Carrie, how much Carrie's helped us out. And everybody.
Thank you, like, Carrie. And thank you, everybody who's been reaching out to check on me.
So many people checking on us. So many people posting up, sharing it out.
Thank you, Kyle, for sending me gifts. I love the book. I have it over here, actually. I love the book. And I love the mushroom butt plug and the harness and stuff. It's really pretty.
And just everything. Yet. Everything that everybody's been doing for us. Like, yes. Thank you guys so much.
Everybody's been sending me, like, helpful tips on things I need to do. Thank you again, everybody.
So yeah, guys, she's getting better. We will be at the shop tomorrow, or today, I guess, is when I release it. But yeah, keep sending love, keep sending positive shit, and stay rotten.
Stay rotten.